Morning, everybody. Would you like to have a seat? Well, good to see you all this morning, and we're able to continue with our said Eucharist. Just a few announcements. This morning's service is going to be recorded by Esther, but just for your own peace of mind, it will only be recorded in this area. So when you come and receive Holy Communion, the cameras won't be rolling there. This is just so we can share the service online. So obviously not everybody is able to be with us at the moment. If you've not been with us since we've reopened, just to remind you that as you come forward for communion, please keep socially distant and stand in the rail rather than kneel, and you will just receive in one kind of bread. As you leave, if we could leave a row at a time, and we leave by the door by the Lady Chapel. That would be wonderful, thank you. I just have some banns of marriage to publish. I'll do now. So I publish the banns of marriage between Clive Seddon and Jean Taylor, both of this parish. If any of you know a cause or just impediment why these two persons should not be joined together in holy matrimony, you are to declare it. And this is for the third and final time of asking. So to our service of Holy Communion. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Would you like to stand? The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments, and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry, and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we say the Gloria together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you. We praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Merciful God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as pass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love towards you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises, which exceed all that we can desire.
Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Well, actually, it's about not weeding. well-known one, the parable of the sower. This week is a slightly less well-known one, the parable of the wheat and the weeds. Next week, we're going to encounter some more parables, a series of shorter ones. And quite a few of these parables in the 13th chapter of Matthew's Gospel use agricultural imagery. Seeds, plants, weeds, harvests. As Jackie said last week, Jesus may well have been looking up to see a farmer in the distance as he told these parables. This imagery would have certainly been familiar to Jesus' disciples. In today's parable of the wheat and the weeds, Jesus addresses, at least in part, the question of the existence of evil in our world. The field, Jesus says, represents the world. The Son of Man, which is one of the titles for Jesus that Matthew uses in his Gospel, sows good seed into that field. The good seed represents children of the kingdom, those who by faith have been adopted into God's family, i.e. Christians. The children of the kingdom are not alone in the world, though. Other seed is put in. The parable tells us that the enemy of God has been at work, and there are children of the evil one in the world too. People who have rejected God as Father. In the parable, the servants want the field to be pure. They want to get rid of those weeds and leave only the good seed. Now, in a garden, that is a pretty good plan. But in a parable in which the field represents our world, this is unrealistic. The master, representing God, knows that it is not as simple as just taking out the weeds. Hopefully, pretty sure, none of us like evil. And we would all want to live in a world where there is absolutely no evil. And this desire can lead us to ask questions like, why does God allow this? We want a field free of weeds. We want a world free of evil. Jesus explains through this parable that it's not quite that simple. Evil has entered our world, and getting rid of it can risk also damaging or even completely getting rid of the good in the world. The master in the parable stops the servants from weeding for fear that they might pull up the wheat too. He tells the servants that they need to wait. We worship a God who is good and who is just. Our God promises justice. We do live in an unjust world. Did you ever whinge as a child that something wasn't fair and have an adult turn to you and say, life's not fair? I certainly did. And they were right. There is injustice in this world. So why doesn't God just get rid of it? Well, there might be a few occasions when we are all agreed on actions or situations. Generally, if we're honest, it's more complicated, isn't it? Good and evil can exist alongside each other. A person can be a Christian, but also still be tempted by evil desires. A person can have rejected God as Father, but can still act as a child of God. If we rid the world of all evil, we might just end up ridding it of most of the people. So instead, we wait for justice. Our God is good and he is just and he will return in power to judge. Our God is a loving and a merciful God, and by his grace is prepared to look on Christ and not on us in that judgment. It's not only us that are waiting for justice, it's God too. He doesn't like seeing this world full of injustice any more than we do. But he also doesn't want to weed too soon and risk losing children of the kingdom. Have having patience with this waiting can be extremely difficult and sometimes painful. It can feel like God doesn't care, or it may even seem like God isn't good and just, especially if we suffer ourselves. The completion of the overthrow of evil is yet to come, but this of course doesn't mean that God is inactive. God is with us in the field, nurturing the children of the kingdom. We are not waiting in vain or without action. We know that when Jesus rose from the dead, he won victory over all evil and death. And so we can wait in full hope that the outworking of this victory will be completed. We don't want to look at a garden full of weeds, especially if we can see the weeds growing and doing damage to the other plants. We don't want to look out at a broken world, especially if we can see injustice triumphing. This parable reminds us that even though the view can be horrible sometimes, the garden will one day be completely renewed, pure and perfect. So let us live patiently in the sure and certain hope that we do not wait for justice in vain. And let us be active for good, knowing that God is with us and working through us. Amen.
Join us again. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
priests and deacons, especially at this time, on Archbishop Stephen as he takes up his new appointment at York. We also give thanks for the ministry of Archbishop Justin and our Bishops Julian, Philip and Jim. Keep them in your love, give them understanding hearts filled with true love for your people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving Father, as once again we begin to share our lives with others who are dear to us, help us to live as those who have heard and received the word, that we may be bearers of good news and doers of good works. May this community be a field which you have blessed and bring forth a good harvest. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, God of all mercy, we bring before you our brothers and sisters who would like to worship with us, but are unable because of ill health or because they are still restricted as a result of vulnerability. Bless them with your peace, grant them courage and a firm faith. Give to those who care for them or support them your gift of grace and compassion. As members of one family, we pray for one another in the love of your Holy Spirit and for the sake of Jesus Christ. And we pray for those on our sick list, Eileen Carroll, Lillian Gordon, Samantha, Tom Kinsman, Maureen Woodward, Pauline Greenwood, Karen Lee, Heather Stiller, Derek Greenwood, Cindy Westwell, Charlie Henderson, Young Harry Spence, Baby Alistair, Irene May, Mother Enid, Olivia Lola, Rosemary Rowe, Katie Clare, Evelyn Burton, Jean Burrows, Rod Wilson, Jean Davis, Linda Hayward, Walter Jackson, Sandra Harker, Joan Entwistle, and Keith Rawlins. Lord, in your mercy,
hear.
At present, there are many people mourning the loss of loved ones. Look with compassion on those who grieve. In the midst of their sorrow, may they know that they can rest on your love and receive strength from your presence. Father, welcome into the joy and peace of your kingdom those who have departed out of this life to be with you. Help us to leave them in your safe hands, knowing that you love them and have prepared a place with you forever. And we remember today Eddie Stowe, David Holt, Ruth Parkinson, and Anne Marie Friedman. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We also remember the anniversary of those whose death is in this coming week. And we remember today James Parry Airy, Alfred Jenkins, William Swales, Violet Madison, Sandra Clay, Fred Carter, Christopher Dennis Stockdale, Wilfred Taylor, Nellie Batty, James Tyson Sager, Sydney Goldroger, Mae Clayton, and Aidan Laffin, Edith Alice Holstead, and Arthur Entwistle. Rest eternal, grant them, Lord, and let thy perfection shine. May they rest in peace. We offer our prayers in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Matthew, our patron, and all the saints, as we say, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour.
We stand for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us acknowledge one another with an assignment, please. Please be obviously there's no collection at this point, and there is an offertory plate on your way to if you've not made an offertory on your way if you'd like to make an offertory. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Please do be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You gave us breath and speech that with angels and archangels, and with all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms upon the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends. And taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking a cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. We remember his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son, as we eat and drink these holy things in your presence. Form us in the likeness of Christ, and bring us into a living temple to your glory. Bring us at the last with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Saint Matthew and all the saints, to the vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. And so let us pray with confidence in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
God of our pilgrimage, you have led us to the living water. Refresh and sustain us as we go forward on our journey. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. myself separate from you, in case anything happens, of course. But I'd say I don't wish you all a really lovely day, and hope you enjoy the rest of Sunday. And so too the blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you, and remain with you always. Amen.